All right, this is a laptop that I truly respect. May I introduce to you the tablety laptop, Microsoft Surface Pro 7. Let's go over the raw stats. The Surface Pro 7 is a 2-in-1 laptop, combining the best features of a tablet and a laptop such as a touchscreen and Windows 10. Given this, it starts at $750, but I actually don't recommend that model because its specs just don't justify the price. Instead, we are going over the $900 configuration, which is frequently on sale. With this, you get a display that has a resolution that is well beyond 1080p despite looking like someone just mashed random numbers onto the keyboard. The display is 12.3 inches, which admittedly is a little bit small, but bear in mind that many of the features have to be in that middle ground between allowing this device to be able to be carried around like a tablet while also being able to work like a laptop. I personally think the size is negligible given the features. Speaking of which, the Surface Pro 7 has a lot of standouts, one of which is its connectivity. For its size, it's great, but it could use an extra USB port. For internal specs, the Surface Pro 7 is fine. It can do what you need it to do with minimal problems, just no high intensity or extreme gaming or graphics related work. But my problem is the Surface Pro 7 is running 2-year-old tech now. Microsoft is not great at consistently releasing up-to-date devices. If you can wait, there are rumors of a Surface Pro 8 coming out later this year with better specifications. But if you can't, again, the Surface Pro 7 has fine specs for what you need. Lastly, for storage, the Surface Pro 7 starts at 128GB, which isn't a lot, but like I said in my Surface Go 2 video, I also run a MacBook Pro with 128GB of storage completely fine using an external SSD. But if you go this route, that requires a lot of routine maintenance and deleting on your end, especially when you use this device for work and school. If you think you can't constantly maintain the storage of your laptop, I'd recommend either speccing it out with more or buying an external SSD. I recommend these. Now, you may be wondering, why do I have such an affinity toward this laptop? Truthfully, it's just because it's so usable. It doesn't have many unnecessary features. It's just a laptop and a tablet. It's great for students like me. You get to use the device for taking notes in class, and when you get home, you can use the device to complete any schoolwork that's required. In today's age, tablets and Chromebooks, although portable, cannot be used for everything. They're not always great for daily drivers. For instance, CAD and some exam proctoring programs do not work well on tablets. Conversely, taking notes on a computer can be a pain, but it's easy on a tablet. Microsoft, with this device, took the best features of a computer and a tablet and morphed them into this machine. It's wonderful. Now, other compromises? Of course. Always. This includes the screen. It's small. I get it. But some sacrifices are worth it. And in this case, I think Microsoft did pretty well. Now, do I recommend purchasing this laptop right now? Well, if you haven't made your decision already, despite it being the end of the back-to-school season, I would recommend waiting for the Surface Pro 8. Now, I know I've been praising the Surface Pro 7 a lot, but I want the best for you. And I think that Microsoft will improve on the Surface Pro 7 and make the Surface Pro 8 even better. But if you can't wait and you're already sold on the Surface Pro 7, get it. Just make sure that if you get the 128GB version, get an external SSD on top of that. It'll be great for work and school and will last for years. But ultimately, all of this is your decision based on your preferences. Don't just watch one single video about this device. I've linked many more down in the description to view at your discretion. Thank you very much for watching. Good luck with your purchase and have a wonderful day.